Would you like to know 6 things that you should never say or do when you go out house hunting?
If you would, stay tuned.
Welcome back. My name is Kathryn Larkin.
And I'm Tom Steck.
And together we are
the TomKat Team.
The first thing you need to be aware of is
hidden cameras. In this modern age of technology, a lot of homeowners have installed cameras inside their homes. Now, they didn't do it to spy on buyers, but it happens to work out that way anyway. So if you have comments that you'd like to make about the home that are good or bad, if there are things that you want to pick up and hold and caress, don't do it.
Don't do it. The second thing is price and strategy. Please, please make sure that when you are touring a home, and if you think the price is ridiculously high, and you're thinking, my goodness, how could the sellers ever possibly come up with this price? Please, don't say it. On the flip side, what if you think it's priced really, really low? You don't want to comment about price while you're at the property, in case the sellers hear you, or if they're not home, remember number one, we talked about hidden cameras. You don't want to talk about price and your strategy while you are in the property.
Number three that we talked about is the idea that you have to remember this is not your home, even though it may be in the future. So don't go through drawers, don't open cabinets, don't rifle through things. We had a seller one time say that one of the buyers who had come through the home came out of her bedroom and said, gee, I noticed you fold your underwear. I think that's a little too much information that the buyer really didn't need to have. So remember, this is not your home, so treat it like you were a guest in the home, which is what you are.
Now, you have every right to open the cabinets, open the drawers in the kitchen, but not someone's personal belongings. You do not want to go through anybody's personal belongings, and especially you don't want to make any comments about that as well.
Yeah.
Number four, do not use the commode. Do not. There's no excuse. Do not ask me. Do not ask Tom. Do not ask the seller. Don't just assume you can go and use someone else's restroom. Remember when we were children and we would go on these fun car rides with your parents and your parents told you to hold it in? Well, hold it in. Do not use someone else's restroom. They will know, believe me, they will know if you've used their commode.
What if they don't want you to. What if the water's been turned off?
Yes.
Surprise! So just skip it.
We have had that numerous times where we were showing a vacant property and the buyer thought, nobody's around. I'll just go over and use the commode. Well,
guess what?
When there's no water, there's no flushing. Now what are we going to do? Hello, and also remember we talked about number one? What if, again, there's a hidden camera? Don't trust people these days when you go into somebody else's home. Please, don't use the commode.
Number five, and I'm almost out of fingers here, is renovations and decorations.
Now, you may not like the way somebody else decorated their home. That doesn't really matter. It's not your home yet, like Tom has said before. Do not get hung up on the decorations. And please don't comment if the seller could hear that you don't like someone's decoration. Maybe you don't like that old Victorian style, but the seller absolutely loves it. So please be careful when you comment on the decorations. And then the second thing is the renovations. A lot of people like the open kitchen concept. They want to knock down some walls, maybe make a bigger bedroom or what have you. That's fine and dandy. But if you keep talking about it and if the seller hears it, they're going to think, what, Tom?
That you have an awful lot of money and therefore they don't need to negotiate with
Correct.
You in terms of price.
Correct. You are hurting your negotiation skills. The sixth and final thing that you really should not do or say when you are touring someone's home is?
Don't bring the whole world with you. You're the one buying the house, maybe another person, but I've had properties being shown where there's the buyer, the buyer's parents, the buyer's kids, and it gets a little hard to keep track of everybody.
We know it's really nice to have another person's opinion of the home. We get it. We get that you may want mom and dad or a friend of yours to come there with you. But please try to limit how many people go into the home. If you have children, I know sometimes you have to bring the kids with you. Try not to, but if you do, please keep an eye on the kids. So these six things are things that Tom and I have had to deal with throughout the many years of us doing real estate. So please, please keep all of this in mind when you're going out house hunting. We hope you have a wonderful time. And once you've found your fabulous dream home, you may want to watch this upcoming video about how important home inspections are.
Thanks for watching.
I'm Kathryn Larkin.
And I'm Tom Steck.
And remember, we sell paradise in Pinellas.